Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today let me show you how to create your own custom version of the Big Sur wallpaper. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 800 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. Now people have different reactions to the default Big Sur background. It's bright and colorful and kind of matches what you see in iOS as well. But some people would rather it not be so bright or maybe just be a single color with different shades. Well, you can easily customize and create your own version of this wallpaper, and you can keep the light and dark mode functionality as well. So first let's start by finding the actual desktop wallpaper file. To do that, in the Finder, create a new Finder window, and we're going to navigate using the Go menu to the computer level. From there we're going to go into your main hard drive, and then into System, and then Library. So it's important you're in System Library, not just Library. Under here, you'll find a folder called Desktop Pictures. And this is where all the default system desktop wallpapers are stored. The one we're looking for is called Big Sur Graphic. Now we're going to copy this by going to Edit and then Copy, or just Command C. We can't change the one in the system folder, and we really don't want to. We want to have that one to go back to just in case. So let's go now and create a new tab here in the Finder, so we can go to a new location. And here I am in my Documents folder. And that would be actually a good place to store our custom version. But instead, I'm going to use go to Home, and then go into the Pictures folder. That might even be a better place. Here I'm going to create a new folder, and I'm going to call this Desktop Pictures. And I'm going to paste a copy of this file in here. So Edit, Paste Item. And now we can see a copy of the default background. Now if I double clicked on it to open it up, it's actually going to open up in a third party graphics app that I have installed, which isn't going to work because this file actually contains two images, the light mode and the dark mode. So I'm instead going to control click on it and then choose Open With and then Preview. So just using the Preview app that's built into your Mac already. And here we can see that there are indeed two images in this one file, the light version and the dark version. So let's start with the light version here. I'm going to use the minus button a couple times so I can shrink it and see its edges a little easier. Now let's go and alter this. So I'm going to use Tools and then Adjust Color. And this brings up some color adjustment tools built into the Preview app. Now any one of these can be used to adjust the colors here. The one I'm going to use right now is Saturation. I'm going to desaturate this, basically turn it into a grayscale image. So I still have the light and darks, but the colors are gone. Now I could simply go and use Tint now to tint it and make it a green version or a purple version. I could even then change the temperature, so change purple to red or to blue. So using these two controls, you can actually do a lot to change the color. But I'm going to show you a different technique that will more easily get to the exact color that you want. So with it desaturated all the way down, I'm going to close this window here. Then I'm going to go to the markup tools if I don't already see them there. If I don't see these markup tools, click this button here to get to them. Now I'm going to create a rectangle. That's going to put this rectangle here. I'm going to alter the rectangle clicking here to set the fill to a color. So I'm going to choose a blue color like that. Then I'm going to take the border away. So I'm going to click here and then click here to remove the border. Now let's go and alter the color a little more. I'm going to click here and then show colors. And then using the color wheel here, I can adjust the color a little more to get it to what I want. But also I'm going to take the opacity and drop that down. Let's drop it down to something like maybe 40%. Now you can see how this acts as a tint to tint the background there. I'm going to now drag this so it's above the upper left hand corner and drag the corner so it's below the bottom right. And now you can see how it tints the entire thing. I can continue to play with the colors here, work in the color wheel, and get exactly what I want. So now I've got something like that that's kind of like a light blue. Now let's go to the dark version here and then go to Tools, Adjust Color, and drop the saturation down. And now I'm going to create a rectangle just like I did before, and you can see it remembers the previous settings, which makes it really easy. And now I could add this here. So now I've got my dark version and the light version. So if these are what I want, now I can just save and close this. So now you can see back in the Finder here I've got my custom version. Let's name it something a little different. I'm going to call it custom. It's a Big Sur custom. Now let's use that as desktop background. All we need to do for that is go to System Preferences, Desktop and Screensaver, and then I just can drag this into here. And now it sets that as my background. So now you can see my desktop background is set to that. If I look at the dark mode version, you can see here using Control Center I can switch in dark mode. And you can see I get that other version there. Now note that when we open this up again in preview, the changes we've made have been permanently applied. So there's no more floating rectangle above this. It's actually applied to the image itself. So if we wanted to create another one, we would have to start over again and grab that original graphic image. There are other things we can do with this as well. For instance, maybe we want to put some sort of graphic over this. One way to do that would be to use Keynote. So in Keynote, create a new document and choose something like the basic white. I'm going to select everything here and get rid of all that text. Now let's add a shape. I'll click here and then I'll find a shape. Let's use Nature and maybe select this plant right here. I'm going to make it a lot larger and just put it right here in the middle. And now I'm going to set its color. So I'm going to click here to open up the colors. Let's pick some sort of dark blue. But let's set it to 50% opacity right there. Now I'm going to copy this. I find it helps if you click off of it first and then click it to select again and then go Edit Copy. Then let's switch back to Preview and I'm going to Command V to paste it in and you can see it pastes in right there. Let's get it nice and centered like that. And I could resize it if I wanted to. Let's go now and save this. And now we'll set the desktop background again. System Preferences, Desktop and Screensaver. We can see it already shows the new copy because we've updated the file it's referring to. But the desktop doesn't update right away. So one thing you can do is just switch to another desktop like this one and then switch to your new desktop. And now we'll see the change applied. Now you could paste anything you want in here. So if you find a semi-transparent image online, you can paste that in there. If you've got a company or personal logo, you can paste that in there as well. You can actually just paste a large image completely over this and replace both the light and dark mode with different versions of that image. Note if I do Command I here, I can see that this is a 6,016 square image. So if you're creating something in a graphics app, make sure you create it that size for the best quality. So now you can get creative and create your own version of Apple's Big Sur desktop background or create something completely new from scratch.
I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.